Namaste, bitch, how are you? I'm not very well. Do you know why? Thanks, Tiger Air. Hello, maybe you are expecting to see a video about good things, but I'm so sorry. At this time, I'm going to tell you something horrible that happened to me. Not only with me, but with lots of people recently in Gold Coast, here in Australia. And when my holiday finished, I had to come back to Sydney, because I live in Sydney. But in the day that I had to come back to Sydney, the weather was really horrible. And can you imagine what happened? The airport wasn't closed, but because the weather was really horrible, it was raining a lot and it was foggy, you couldn't see too much, some flights couldn't come to Gold Coast. And you know when you see in a screen in the airport about all the flights landed or late or whatever? Okay, they put one information that because the weather was horrible, the flight wasn't there. And after like 2 hours waiting, they told us that our flight was cancelled and we should go to a line to see what they could do. But I do understand, in that kind of situation, there's nothing to do, there's no flight. What else more can you do? Maybe think about go to the next one or the next one. They told us that we should take our baggage. I don't know the name. Do you know the place that you take your bags? I don't know the name of this baggage, carrier. We could take this in number one. And we were waiting. And to be true, all the bags were in number three. And while we were waiting for a long time, lots of people were in the queue already trying to rearrange the flight for the next one. We were the last people. All of us that had bags. When we arrived in the queue, it was huge. I lost the flight at 9 o'clock, so they arranged people for 1 o'clock, some people for 7 o'clock. Not sure about the time. And people were quite calm, and I was thinking, okay, maybe it's alright. Everybody's going to go to Sydney in another time. Because at this time, the weather wasn't so good, but all the flights was arriving in the airport. So everything was alright. After 1 hour and 10 minutes, one lady from Tiger Air, to be honest, they weren't from Tiger Air. Because Tiger Air is such a good company that they don't have people in Gold Coast. So it's a kind of people that work in another company, but represents their company. It's very confused, but it's the way that they work there. I don't know why. One lady, she told to a lot of people, I'm so sorry, but from now, everybody that is in this queue cannot have any flight booked for this day. So we can book you guys for the next 2 days, or we can give you your money back. Everybody was pretty stressed in this line, of course, because you cannot wait for 2 days to come back to your life, especially in the end of the year, and have your money back. Imagine buy another ticket in the last minute for the same day in the end of the year. It's going to cost a fortune, but okay, have nothing to do. I was pretty stressed, to be honest. I was really stressed. But this girl, she was pretty cool. She was trying to understand our frustration, and she was dealing really well with this. We are still waiting in the queue until the time that I had to choose. And this girl in this desk, she was pretty tough, very bad person with very bad skills with customer service. And she was like this.
Please hang up and try again.
She just told me, look, I can book you for the next 2 days or give you your money back. I said, look, can't you try to put me in another company? Because come on, I really need to come back. No, I cannot change anything and I'm not responsible for the weather. I was pretty shocked with this attitude and I said, excuse me? When you have nothing to do in that situation, what else more can you do? Okay, give me my money back. Okay, your money is going to be back to you in 5 days in your credit card. Say, excuse me, 5 days? So if I have no money now and you're not giving my money back, how can I book another flight in 5 days? So I have nowhere to stay, nowhere to go, and no money to book another flight. Thank you very much, Tiger Air, to leave me in that place with any condition. You are such a company. And I was really prepared to have a fight with this girl because she was horrible. I don't know what she was doing there. And I was complaining to everybody. I said, look, I want to talk with her manager. And another girls that were working at there told me, I'm sorry, but the manager is not here. I said, what? What happened with this company? So they don't have people here. You guys are responsible, but the responsible is not here. So what happened to us? You're still here. I'm sorry, but you can do nothing. If the weather is horrible and they have to cancel, they have to give you the money back or put you in another airplane. I understand this. But I really understand that the company need to think about your customer. Why I'm telling you this? Because a long time ago, 1 year ago specifically, I was in Uluru. And when I was coming back to Sydney, the flight was cancelled and I was traveling by Jetstar. In the same time, the company, what they had done to all of us, while we were waiting for explanations, they gave 2 vouchers for each person to have food while we were waiting because we were in the airport. And when we had an explanation, they booked everybody for the next day trip because unfortunately no more possibilities to fly back to Sydney. They put us in a 5-stars hotel. They pay us our lunch, our dinner, and our breakfast in the next day. And also, they gave us a $100 voucher to fly another time with Jetstar. Wow, this was awesome. Maybe it wasn't their obligation to give all these things to us, but they thought about customers. And this was so amazing because they showed me respect. And what happened with Tiger Air? Show no respect, show no care. Maybe you're doing the correct things, but you know, one company that don't think about their customers, do you think deserves that we fly with them? Really? I know nothing is going to change, but when they don't care about me, I don't care about them as well. It doesn't matter if it's a cheap fare. Cheap fare, you can fly by another companies as well. Jetstar is one example. I pay another fly with Virgin. I pay almost $400, but it's okay because I had to come back to Sydney. And at 7 o'clock, I was there waiting to come back to Sydney. I came back to the airport. And you know what happened? Don't know why. All the flights was alright, but this flight that was coming to Gold Coast to Sydney, it was cancelled from Tiger Air. Yes, one more time, Tiger Air cancelled. And it was funny, I don't think it was because of the weather, because everything was alright. And imagine the situation, lots of people were waiting since the morning to come back to Sydney using this horrible company called Tiger Air. And they cancelled one more time at 7 o'clock. People were so stressed. And you know what happened? And I was happy flying by Virgin. I was back to Sydney and lots of people were outside. So, good on you, Tiger Air, for showing no respect, for showing that you don't care about people, for showing that you are this kind of company that do not respect people. And more than this, don't understand that people sometimes have no money. And I understand the weather is horrible, but if you are a serious company, you should think to give at least a little of comfort for these people. Maybe food, maybe one cup of coffee or whatever, and not treat people like this. So today I can tell you that I hate Tiger Air. I think the worst company in the world. Look, I don't know what to say about this company. So if I were you, think about your money, because sometimes you think, okay, I'm going to pay not too much, and I pay a lot at this time, but sometimes when you pay less, you have a very, very horrible headache, and the less is going to cost you a fortune after all this. Sorry for telling you that horrible case, but I think important we share horrible things so people can prevent themselves to live this horrible experience, don't you think? That's it. And I hope to see you next time. That's it. Namaste, bitch. See you soon. Bye.